Dear friends, in this video, I am going to discuss about why independent directors have started to safeguard their personal assets. Do you want to be an independent director? Then your personal assets can be attached as per Section 212 of the Companies Amendment Bill Act 2019. The scope of the Section 212 of the Companies Act 2019 has been expanded, and the central government may file an application before the NCLT for holding any director personally liable without any limitation of liability. So the central government may move to NCLT to hold any director, including independent director, personally liable without any limitation of liability. The move by MCA to freeze the assets of the independent directors of defaulting companies, among other stringent measures, have also led to concerns and growing exodus of independent directors from listed companies. When the law does not safeguard the rights of independent directors, they have to be very careful. An independent director has to attend at least 6 board meeting or committee meetings in a year in which he is working as an independent director, and he has to spend considerable time towards that company. An independent director cannot be held liable for the actions of the promoter, director or the management if they collude with each other and indulge in fraud and deceit and hide facts to independent directors. Independent directors are not given the kind of rights to safeguard corporate governance and to take action, and are they encouraged to dissent by most promoters. In reality, the compensation paid to independent directors are very low as compared to the risk they are facing. If something goes wrong in the company, the accountability and responsibility is very awesome. However, today the law has improved amendments for independent directors. The independent directors are accountable for matters only brought to his attention. In the last line of defenses, he is accountable only after credit rating agencies, international auditors, who are also likely to be questioned. As per Section 212 of the Companies Act Amendment 2019, if there is any fraud, the government can approach the NCLT against any director, including independent director, holding them personally liable without any limitation of liability, and to seek to attach their personal assets. In the last 3 years, courts are ordering the attachments of personal properties of independent directors. If at all qualified professionals can be convinced to come on board as independent directors, it will be no surprise if they ensure that assets in their name are very few. NCLT in the Punjab National Bank versus Nirav Modi and Mehul Chokshi allowed the MCA's plea to attach assets of the independent directors on the board of Nirav Modi companies and Chokshi's company. NCLT also upheld the verdict of NCLT. However, Supreme Court had stayed the above verdict. Likewise, in IL and FS case, MCA expanded the ambit of its investigation to include independent directors also. So now, due to Section 212 of the Companies Act 2019 amendment, IDs have to ring-fence their assets by way of transferring it to a family trust. IDs are now looking at tightening directors and officers' D&O liability insurance to safeguard them and their assets from all and every possible claim made while serving on board of listed companies. So it is very now awesome for them. So now the serving as a director in a listed company as an independent director is very, 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 very risky, and independent directors have to think many time before accepting the position of independent director in any listed company. Friends, thank you for watching this video. I hope this information will be very useful to you. If you like this video, I request you to please subscribe my channel. Thank you once again. RV Shagar, practicing company secretary.